Hi, I'm Steve Johnson, Farm and Ag Business Management Specialist with Iowa State University Extension and Outreach. Let's take a look at three distinct components of crop marketing. The first one, basis, the difference between the local cash price, the blue line in this graphic, and the underlying futures price of a commodity, the red line. Notice that the difference between the two we define as basis. The basis is typically wider at harvest than it is as we get further into the marketing year. The other important component to recognize is that basis tends to be a negative number, as cash prices in most of the Corn Belt is less than the futures price. Also, when you view the video on hedging, the important consideration that there is a relationship between the cash price and the futures price, and they tend to move together through the marketing year. Futures carry the difference between futures contract prices of the same commodity. I think of futures carry as either stair steps going up, very typical, or stair steps going down. Most years we think of typical futures carry in the market, but a year like 2012 and the drought, we actually saw inverted carry. Cost of storage. The estimated cash cost of storing corn in a commercial facility versus on-farm. Let's use corn with a value of $3.50 per bushel cash price. But interest accruing, whether the interest be on the on-farm storage facility or on money that you've borrowed against corn that's being stored. An initial 20-cent per bushel lift charge for handling those bushels. And then note either the blue line, the on-farm storage cost, or the red line, the commercial storage cost. Storage isn't free. And it's important to recognize your own cost of storage. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I'm Steve Johnson, Farm and Ag Business Management Specialist, Iowa State University Extension and Outreach.